Hi, my name is Josh McCarthy, and I want to welcome you to another edition of our Ask the Experts weekend here on 104.5 WOKV. And this show is dedicated to you, the workforce of today and tomorrow. Pete, the Job Guy Langlois, introduces his listeners to the most innovative companies, and he explores the career journeys behind some of the world's most influential individuals. And this is all done with an honest and oh-so-entertaining filter that is unique to Pete, the Job Guy Langlois. Take it away, Pete.
Hello out there, all you hard workers. Well, you did it. You made a great decision today, and that is listening to Hard Worker with Pete the Job Guy. After all, the show is dedicated to you. We talk all about jobs and careers, and we give you information that's going to help you to be more effective and productive in your careers. Now, guys, as always, my semi-world-famous co-host is here, and that is Angie Langlois. Say hey, Angie.
What's up, Jacksonville? Go Jags.
Go Jags is right. Go Jags next year. Okay. Great job, guys, this year. Unbelievable. You gave us hope, and that hope turned into a victory in the postseason, and it was exciting. We had a lot of fun. We had watch parties. We tailgated. Everything was great. I cannot wait until next year. So you're right. Go Jags is phenomenal. Guys, if you haven't listened to the show before, there's like three key elements to the show. One is we do give the career advice, and that's always great. You learn something on every show, okay? And we learn something. Angie and I do each and every week. The big part of the show is we introduce you to some folks in Jacksonville that tell you a little bit about their career journey. They share information about the great organizations that they represent. And this is where I really learn something each and every week. And guys, this week is no different. I'm going to introduce you to our guests in just a minute. Another element to the show is we have Boston Dan. And each week, Boston Danny tells us about the fair city of Boston. He brags about his sports teams. He tells us a little ditty about his grandson, Desmond. But he does something special for you guys. If you have a birthday, maybe you have a friend or a special someone in your life, let's say, that's having a birthday or an anniversary, or maybe someone just made your workday a little bit brighter and you'd like to recognize them for it. Well, there's a simple way to do that. You just send me an email. Send your email to Pete@PeteTheJobGuy.com. I'll take that. I'll give it to Boston Danny, and he'll give your special someone a wicked pissa shout out like only Boston Danny can. It's a fun part of the show, and Boston Danny's been around for, gosh, we're almost at our 5-year mark of doing the show. So he's a big part of the show. He makes me laugh each and every week. He's a fellow veteran like me, and we're glad he's on the show. All right, I told you I got some great guests, but I'm going to kind of set the stage a little bit. A lot of you know my story. I grew up in a kind of a blue-collar town, blue-collar city. And we always say the biggest compliment you could give somebody from Tewksbury, Massachusetts isn't, oh, that PETA, he's the smartest or the richest or the best-looking. The biggest compliment you could give somebody from Tewksbury, Massachusetts is that PETA, he's a hard worker. Okay. Hard work is something that is the cornerstone to any recipe for success. And that's always been my philosophy. Well, when I graduated high school, college wasn't an option for me. It wasn't even on the table. I joined the United States Navy, the world's greatest Navy. And I went in and I was a jet engine mechanic, and I worked on A7E Corsairs. It was great. You know, I did go to night school and weekends and got a degree. But when I got out, there wasn't I kept applying for jobs, and I just kept hearing no, no, no. And a buddy of mine had me work for him. He says, I got a job for you. Come work for me. And he ran a brick paver company, and I laid bricks, and I thought I was going to do it maybe for a couple weeks or a couple months or so. Well, 2 years later, I'm laying brick pavers, and I'm telling you what, I never had more fun in my life. I made good money. My buddy Mike was the big money maker. You know, it was his business. The two guys at the top made a lot of money. But when I finally did change jobs and go down into the career path that I really wanted, I took a pay cut of almost half. And it was tough for me because I made good money. We had really cool hours. We drank a lot of beer. We did. I mean, it would be like 2:30, and so it was like, go make a beer run. It was a pretty cool gig. But I have to tell you, look, going to college and then joining the workforce isn't for everybody. My brother Mike is an electrician. His company, TCB Electric, has over 100 people working for him. He's a huge success story. Both of my sisters didn't go to college. Both of them have great jobs. Chrissy's been at the same job for 30 years. Jenny's been for 20 plus. And they're very successful. College is not a career path for everybody. And there are a lot of jobs out there and a lot of ways to achieve success without the piece of paper, because it is not for everybody. And today our guests are going to talk to us about that. I have two guests. Both are from the great company UPS. I have Greg DeFranco, and I also have George Moore. Welcome to Hard Worker with Pete the Job Guy.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you for having us.
I'm so glad you're here. And either one of you start off, tell me, tell me a little bit about UPS and what you do at UPS.
We are in the feeder department, which is the tractor trailer division.
Mm-hmm,
so
yeah.
George and myself are feeder drivers, but we run safety for the department. So there's over 600 feeder drivers, so tractor trailer drivers out of Jacksonville, which you would never probably believe. So we run safety. We keep people safe. We work with new people, train them to keep all the old school rules and the way we were taught alive, you know, because we pride ourselves on our safe driving.
Yeah. Unbelievable. George, how long have you been with UPS?
I've been there 33 years in April.
33 years. And you too, Greg?
Yes.
Same, right on the 33 years. Has it been a good, and would you call it a successful career so far?
Yes, very. You know, you say the college isn't for everybody. You know, I went to college, you know, maybe 30 minutes worth of it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But, you know, college isn't for everybody.
Right.
You know, and back then, that was a thing. You went to college. And mm-hmm. when I started at UPS, it was not going to be my profession. I sure had no dreams of being a truck driver.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then almost 33 years later, here we are. You know, it's not even remotely where I would have pictured my life. Financially, yes, but as far as occupation, no.
Yeah. You know what's interesting is, you know, Greg, did you do the college route too? Did you give it a whirl?
No. I blew baseball scholarships because I thought it was going to get given to me.
Right.
And I knew I had to go to work. I was done with school.
Yeah.
So I knew I had to go to work. My dad was pushing me into the military. I just wasn't interested in that. But I knew I needed to go to work. And a couple of friends of mine went to UPS, and that was a good job.
Mm-hmm.
So I got a part-time job on my own there, and I never thought I would be here 33 years later and 22 years safe driving and doing what we get to do now. It's just amazing with no college.
Well, you know, tell me about kind of a career progression, because over 33 years, I bet you wore a lot of different hats there.
Oh, absolutely.
Tell us a little bit about what that looks like.
Both of us actually started out in the building. Back when we started, that was pretty much the only way to have an occupation there, was you started out in the building, which was loading or unloading, mm-hmm. you know, and then after so many years, you could get a chance to go package, and then after years with that, you would get a chance to go into the feeders, which is what we do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, now it's not that type of progression. We have people that have just turned 21 that's worked at UPS 6 months that are, you know, basically making six figures now. You know, versus where we had to work there 7 or 8 years.
I hope everybody hears this. You got people that have been in there for 6 months making six figures. And are those college grad folks?
No, not by far.
You know, 67% of the workforce in the United States didn't graduate college. The overwhelming majority didn't graduate mm-hmm. college. You know, some of the most successful people that work with me,
mm-hmm.
are not college graduates. Are they less smart than the next person? No. One of the people I've told them, no matter what room we're in, and I don't want to say his name because his head gets big every time I tell him, no matter what room we're in, if you're in this room, I know who the smartest person in the room is. It's not me. It's going to be you, and I don't care who else is in the room, you know? So it's interesting. So you work, you come in at one level. How do you progress? Is it just you outwork the next guy, or you keep your eyes open and listen?
It's all based on by seniority.
Mm-hmm,
you know,
mm-hmm.
Of course, we're union, so everything is based on seniority. Everything goes through bid list. You know, and Jacksonville is probably growing faster probably than any other city in the country. Jacksonville's been growing for years, even when things were not necessarily that great. Jacksonville's still growing. You know, and there's in the trucking industry and in the type of stuff that we do. there's tons of warehouses and corporation bases that are in Jacksonville people don't even know about.
Yeah. Well, let's talk about how many employees, Greg, I'll ask you this roughly, how many employees you guys have here in Jacksonville? Is it in the thousands? Is there a comma? What do we have?
About 4,500 at UPS.
4,500 at UPS. Yeah. Oh, sure. Well, okay, go ahead.
So I was just going to ask, so you've got all these listeners out there, what makes UPS different than maybe some of those other companies that people don't know about? Like, what are the extras? What's the sizzle? Like, why come and work for UPS?
Okay, I'll take this one. Okay. So how about pension? You know, when you're young, nobody tells you about a pension. You know what I mean? People don't even know what a pension is. A lot of the kids don't. So a lot of the kids, they don't know about 401k. How about stock options? Being able to buy stock in the company. Vacation time. You know, George and myself, we get 6 weeks a year plus another week of sick days, 8 sick days. So, I mean, you know, where do you go and get that? Now, it takes time to accrue that much, but still, it's where do you go get that? Now, I'll bring another story into this. How about the medical? So, our medical. So, you know my stepson.
Yep.
You know my stepson, Gabe.
I do. Suffer from a traumatic brain injury.
Absolutely.
You know, well,
so my
that's
wife,
not free.
My wife, yep. Jessica, we got married a month before, and I had a concussion at the time, but I told her, I said, look, let's go down to the union hall. Let me get you and the kids on my insurance because they'll cover all of her kids, wow. Her four kids. So she takes me down. I get everybody on, and then this happens. So $3.5 million. I'm going to say that again. $3.5 million of
wow.
medical, and maybe we've come out the pocket $6,000.
That's incredible.
So
it's incredible.
I equate that to I've worked my whole life to save somebody.
Yeah.
You know, a young man. So
wow.
That's why UPS is special, because it's family.
Well, you know, that's pretty incredible. Some of the things that you talked about right there are a foreign concept to most. Most people, like right now, entering the workforce, don't really know what a pension is because almost no one offers one.
Yeah.
Okay? Unless you're in a union or, you know, very specialized fields, you just don't see it. There's nobody in town that I see. You know, my intention, my pension is self-funded, you know, or I do contribute to a 401k and stuff, but there's nothing. And no company that I've worked for, and I work for a major publicly traded multi-billion-dollar company, zero pension, you know. And career longevity is also something you don't see a lot. You know, you got people that work here for six months, a year down here, and, you know, just when they learn where the restroom is and what their phone number is, they leave and go start it all over again. So it's amazing to see that, and to have great medical care that you were able to provide is just pretty incredible. Well, that music right there that we're hearing tells us we have to take a short break right now and listen to this message from our show sponsor. You're listening to Hard Worker with Pete the Job Guy on 104.5 WOKB.
Hey, Jacksonville, it's me, Angie Langlois, one of the managing partners here at Ascendo Resources in Jacksonville, Florida. Ascendo Resources is an award-winning, certified, minority-owned staffing firm that specializes in placing highly skilled professionals on a temporary, temp-to-perm, or direct hire basis. Call the true professionals at Ascendo today, because despite the current challenges, our talented recruiters can find exactly what you need. Call me, Angie Langlois, at 904-479-9610.
All right, welcome back, hard workers. That was our show sponsor, Ascendo Resources. If you need any staffing assistance in Northeast Florida, you call the good folks at Ascendo Resources, and they'll be great. They'll take care of you great. They're always great. They're great people, but they'll take care of you. So our guests today are George Moore and Greg DeFranco of UPS. And, man, like I say, every week when we have our guests on, we learn a lot. And we're talking about career pathing at UPS. We talked about boy, UPS has some unrivaled benefits to working there. And, you know, both the folks that we have on today have been working there for 33 years. And that's something that, you know, career longevity, we just don't see it. People are bouncing around all the time nowadays, but it's so good. And it's a testimony to a great work environment that has a career trajectory, upward mobility. It's very rewarding, or people leave, right? They leave. So what other jobs out there? Are there any open right now that you're aware of at UPS? And if people wanted to just maybe browse for themselves for open jobs, is there a website or somewhere we could direct them?
Yes, you could go to upsjobs.com and then post jobs, what is available in this area or any area for that matter.
Mm-hmm.
And it's basically they're hiring all the time.
Yeah.
I mean, there's always a turnover, and then there's always room for more people.
Right. And where you start at isn't where you end up. So it's like sometimes it's like you get a foot in the door.
Right? Believe it or not, we have people that's been there 40, 45 years that still are part-time.
Right.
But they own their own business.
Yeah.
You know, they're at UPS for the insurance.
Got it.
And they own their own business. And I know there's a couple guys with an electric company. Another guy's got a roofing company. You know, and you would think that they were millionaires the way they live, but it's because they stayed there, you know, just for the benefits.
I mean, that's phenomenal that's even an option. So, you know, what are some of the things you did? Now, if you've been there 33 years, both of you guys are young, man. What did you do before that you did this? Because I love it. I'm going to tell you some of the things I did in the Navy. I told you I laid bricks, but I flipped pizza. I installed office furniture. And then I worked. I was a host. I was a host. You were a waitress. I was a host. And I took that very seriously. I set the seating scheme and, you know, and sat people. What are some of the things you did before this?
It's really the only job I've ever had.
There you go.
I mean, I did a little meaningless stuff, but as far as a real job with a real paycheck, it's the only thing I've ever done.
That's it.
People ask, how do you get used to it, or how do it's all I know.
Yeah.
You know,
right.
I don't know any different other than brown, you know, and having to shave and having to wear a uniform. And, you know, it's been my life for 33 years.
Well, that's pretty awesome, man. No shame in that game. That's awesome. How about you, Greg?
My dad had an Italian restaurant when I was a kid, so I bused tables, and I was a host also.
Yeah, host.
I was raised on that. But then we had a used car lot, too, where we did antique restoration. So I did that because it took me 10 years to get full-time at UPS, so I had to have a side hustle, and that was my side hustle, was restoring cars before I got full-time at UPS. But like George said, it's the only job I've ever had, UPS. So,
all right. Well, over the course of the 33 years, what kind of training have you had, and any certifications that you've achieved to attain? Now you're running a whole safety department too, right? So, what about that?
I mean, really, it's been on the job experience. I mean,
okay.
UPS trains their own as far as CDL drivers are concerned. You know, even when they hire off the street, you still have to go through, you know, the 2-week UPS process. You do it our way, you know, and it's the only way, you know. And there, other companies actually model their training after the way we do things, you know, because it's always been kind of like the military.
Yeah.
You know, it's learn as you go. You get the basics, but then, you know, it's learn as you go. There's no experience better than seat time, you know.
Yeah. And how do you keep a clean driving record for 22? My wife can't do it for 2 years.
when your paycheck depends on it,
right?
It's not that hard.
Absolutely. Right, right.
You know, we nominate people for awards, and we get their driving records, and I look at it, and 1985, they got a DUI where they had 14 speeding tickets. But from 1985 to 2022, they don't have anything. It's amazing how you change, and I know it's that you grow up.
Right.
But when that paycheck on Friday depends on whether or not you can drive, it makes a big difference.
You do it. You do it. And you do it right. That's right. I got this last question I asked my guests. And if I'll let either one of you take this one, but I want you to listen to it, or you both can answer it. This is my time machine question, okay? The time machine. If I put you in a time machine, right, you get to go back in time and meet a younger version of yourself. Maybe 18, 19-year-old, younger version of yourself. You walk right up to your younger self. You put your hand right on your shoulder. You look your younger version of you in the eye and say, let me tell you something, George. Let me give you this bit of advice. This is going to help you in life, whether it's career or otherwise. What advice would you give your younger self?
As far as career-wise?
Yeah.
Don't go to that party. Go to work. I worked at UPS in 1988.
Yep.
And then I had to call in every night, and it's Friday night, and I'm 18.
Yeah.
And I'm doing what 18-year-olds do. Mm-hmm. You know, and I kept calling. They kept telling me to call back, and then finally I said, you know, I'm going to the party.
Right.
And so, of course, they said, we don't need you no more. So
wow.
2 years later, you know, I'm back starting there, and one day or 2 years makes a huge difference in seniority, mm-hmm. you know, especially in the department that we're in.
Yep.
That would be it is... Stay home that night.
That's
work.
That's good advice, and we still tell.
That was a good party,
right?
It was then. Looking back, no, it wasn't.
Right. You know, we always say if you're gonna hoot with the owls at night, be ready to soar with the eagles in the morning, because there's nothing funny about missing work or coming in fuzzy or having a hangover and, you know, slowing your group down or not giving your best performance. So that was a costly lesson. A two-year lesson set you back, right. Anyway. How about you, Greg, what advice would you give your younger self?
I'd say work harder. Not that I didn't work hard. I did work hard, but trust the path.
Mm.
You know, trust the path. We all go through difficult times in life, and, you know, in the end, you seem like you come out on top. So just trust the path.
Right. Outstanding advice. Guys, any last comments? Tell us anything about UPS, or you want to give the contact information one more time if people want to see jobs or learn more about UPS, the website. But if there's any other parting things you'd like to say.
Just upsjobs.com. Just keep looking on. And if you get on part-time, so many jobs around there, so many great jobs, so many good people that work there. It's a family. You get to work with people for a lot of years, and you watch them raise kids, get married, kids become men, you know, the tree of life, you know, you see all that, which is very cool when you get to our age. So stick with it. You know, it's about discipline and staying and loyalty, staying with the company, but just.
That's outstanding stuff. What? Don't be looking at Jay. I tell you, Jay's flashing signals, and he'd throw you off.
He just did. So,
well, listen, I couldn't be happier. I'm so glad you guys came, shared that information with us, and thanks for being on Hard Worker with Pete the Job Guy.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, that was so good. Bye, guys. Oh, they're waving. They're leaving the studio now. That was Greg DeFranco and George Moore, both with UPS. Angie, what do you think? That was some pretty compelling stuff they were telling us.
I mean, I'm talking about the health insurance. And if you guys remember our show with Jess and her son that had a traumatic brain injury and how much money it cost, well, UPS paid for that. $3.5 million, and their out-of-pocket was $6,000. So
great benefits.
I'd say go work for UPS.
You know what I love is just hearing that non-degree jobs pay so much. And we talk,
right.
and when they talk about career pathing within it, and they talk about the hourly rates that people are paid, for some folks, it's mind-boggling, because you can come out with a degree, you know, get your fresh piece of paper, and then you enter the workforce making half of what these jobs pay. So, I mean, and relatively, yeah, they're not skilled through the door, you know, and then you get the OJT and the training mm-hmm. while you're there. It's amazing. I mean, it literally...
It's not talked about enough, and just genuine hard work is not talked about enough either.
Right. I love how George said, you know, I went to college, yeah, for about 30 minutes. I knew it wasn't
They look like a couple party animals.
No,
oh,
those
true.
Guys. Well, you know what? They're serious family men. They're great yeah. guys. They care. They're connected to the community. You know, they're successful. Mm-hmm. I think that's the big thing to say is they're very successful. And, you know, to know that, you know, here they are earning a pension. You know, they've been there 33 years. I'm sure their pensions are substantial, you know. So let's let's just get real. So it's pretty exciting, and I just want to make sure this job isn't to just all the college grads of the world. This is all about the workforce of today and tomorrow, and almost 70% of the workforce is non-degreed, and 70% of that 70% is a lot of people making a lot more money than I make.
That's right.
It's the individual. It's not the piece of paper. All right. Well, that music right there tells us we're coming to the bottom of the hour break. And join us for the second half. You're listening to Hard Worko with Pete the Job Guy on 104.5 WOKV.
Welcome back to Hard Worko to Pete the Job Guy with 104.5 WOKV.
Do the hustle! Oh, welcome back, all you hard workers. Greg DeFranco, George Moore, both from UPS, been working there 33 years, both of them. Exciting, successful careers. Talk to us a lot about, you know, a career path without a college degree, and it was wonderful. Oh, and by the way, that little voice that you just heard welcoming us back from the break, that was Jaden. Jaden's 4 years old, and he is the son of our producer, Jay Bowes, and he's welcome back. With Pizza Show. It's so cute. And he is an unpaid radio talent, extravagant radio, whatever you call him. I don't know.
Up and comer.
He's phenomenal, and we're glad he's a part of the show. Always welcoming us back from each and every break. But man, hearing about UPS, Ange, and how much, you know, folks make, and, you know, walking through the door with a great attitude, an open mind, a willingness to learn, but not a whole lot of skill set through the door.
I'm going to guess that this opens up a whole like Pandora's box, because you and I talk about a very narrow channel now that I'm thinking about it on the professional side. And there's so much more out there that we don't even think about. Like the number one, I'm pretty sure, non-degreed career path is to be an electrician.
Well, you know what? The trades. Yeah. I always said, you know, my brother has a trade. He's an electrician. And, you know, you kind of become recession-proof to a certain degree.
Absolutely.
Because you always have a trade. You know, someone always needs help. And, you know, I know on our chat in our neighborhood the Facebook page, someone's always saying, where can I get a good electrician? Or does anybody
or a roofer or
who
plumber.
Does the windows? Yeah. Well, yeah. Plumbers, roofers, framers, drywallers, brick masons, all these trades pay a lot. Mechanics, a UPS fleet mechanics, I would hate to tell you how much they make right now, because if you're going out into the workforce, it's probably double what you're about to make. And when you take the starting pay for a qualified mechanic,
the Langlois household knows that mechanics are expensive. That is one thing we do know.
You learn that the hard way. But look, a lot of sales jobs, you're paid based on your ability to, you know, how hard you work and your ability to be influential and understand your product and explain the features and benefits. And then the more you put into it, the more you get out of it. And some of the best people in our profession are non-degreed.
Right.
Recruiters that I've met.
Business
some of the very
owners.
Best.
I mean,
yeah,
you name it.
Yeah. Some other roles, police. Firefighters, technology jobs, sound engineers, even truck drivers that we talked about today. These are a lot of highly compensated positions that for the most part are non-degreed, you know. And some you get certifications and specialties, and others that you pick up after a year or two of apprenticeship. It's just amazing. And I just want to let everybody know that if you do not have a degree, that doesn't mean, you know, it's the only pathway to success, because it certainly isn't.
And that's correct.
We heard a lot about it from Greg and George today, so I'm very thankful they came on the show today. Holy cow, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to play Lightning Round. Lightning Round is a trivia game.
Oh my gosh, terrible trivia.
The two contestants today are the semi-world famous Angie Langlois. Say wahoo.
Wahoo!
And our producer, who, let me tell you something, he's slumming. He's the producer for a nationally syndicated radio show. But you know what he does? He just likes us. So he comes and does us. J-Bo!
What's going on?
I get my traffic every day from Jay, too. Every morning I listen to him driving in. I hear him do the traffic, and it's awesome in the morning. So, okay, guys, this is trivia question. The way I do it is I'm going to ask one person. You either give me the right answer or an incorrect answer. If you give me the right answer, you get a point. If you give me an incorrect answer, the other person has an opportunity to earn that point. Okay?
Okay.
And the first person to get 5 correct is the winner. The trivia is a range. I hand-selected by me. And who would like to go first?
Ladies first.
Ladies first. Okay, Angie.
Yay.
The first question is, when one is envious, they are said to be what color?
Green.
That is correct. Bing, 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 bing. Angie gets 1. 1 point to Angie. All right, Jay.
Yes.
Who is the author of Jurassic Park?
Michael Crichton.
Yes, sir.
Wow. Bing, bing. Look at those smart ones.
Okay, Angie. What item is the werewolf most afraid of?
What item? I know vampire. Silver?
Yes!
I was hoping you wouldn't get it.
Yes, it is. And J-Bo's, in which sport is the America's Cup awarded? If you win the America's Cup.
Oh, man.
America's
Cup? Well, I know it's
Cup?
Not football.
Yes. It is not football.
Hockey?
I can't give you credit. No, that's the Stanley Cup. So Jay gets the X. Angie, you get the, for the steal.
Can you repeat the question?
Yes. In which sport is the America's Cup awarded? That's the biggest trophy on the biggest stage for this one sport.
Is it baseball? Tennis?
No. You want me to keep taking points out? Okay, the good thing is the score is still 2-1. No point awarded on that one. It was sailboat racing.
What?
Sailboat racing. If you win sailboat racing, you get the America's Cup.
I'm not a captain. So.
Okay, yeah. Angie, this question is to
We're
you.
We're going
to
throw that one
this
out.
This question is to you, and it's pretty easy. Which children's show is known for its blue dog?
Oh, my gosh. And this is not
Jay's
fair.
Jay's already smiling. He's got
Jay
a four-year-old. He's going to eat this one. Come on. You got to give me the top 3. Two,
what is that called? It's
one,
like I can see them right now.
You're out.
Okay.
Jay, would you enlighten her?
Blue's Clues.
Oh, my
yes,
gosh. I don't think I would have got that.
It's 3-1. All right, Jay, this one goes to you. What is the name of the Royal English Family's residence?
Buckingham Palace.
That is correct. That's 4, Angie. 4-1. He's eating your lunch here.
Wait, no. I got 2.
Yeah.
Oh, you do have 2. That is correct.
Oh, look. See, you got to watch that guy.
I almost had her. Okay. Angie, if you were born on Christmas Day, what would your star sign be?
What?
What's your zodiac sign, some people call it?
Oh.
If you were born on Christmas Day, December 25th.
Capricorn.
Capricorn. Yes, you're correct. It's Capricorn.
That would have been my guess, too.
Okay. 4-3, Jay, for the win. Okay. Oh, boy. This one's pretty easy. Which mammal is known to have the most powerful bite in the world?
Ooh.
Ooh, he's thinking. The gears are turning. But so is the clock. 5, 4,
lion.
3. No, it's not the lion, Angie, for the steal. Which mammal is known to have the most powerful bite in the world? 5, 4, 3, 2.
How about a
1.
Wolf?
No, it's not a wolf.
Wait, can
That's
I guess
a good
one more?
No, it's a hippopotamus. It's hard. It's hard,
oh
but I get
gosh.
It. I get it.
Those are mammals.
It is.
It's a reptile.
It's definitely a cross between.
It's a bird. All right. That next one's easy. So, Angie, so they bring you up to 3. Okay. What's the only mammal that's able to fly? I heard this one not long before.
Is a bat a mammal?
Yes, it's a bat. Okay. For crying out loud, 4-4, Jay for the win, and I think you're going to get this one, okay? What's a baby goat called?
A kid.
Yes. That's it. Jay is the winner of the trivia.
And you win nothing.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, Jay gets an all-expense-paid trip to nowhere. He gets nothing. While he's on that trip, he's going to get 500 nothings, and he gets to bring nobody with him. Jay Moes!
Not even a t-shirt, huh? Not even a t-shirt.
Now, listen, when we played trivia, what was it, a couple weeks ago?
Last week.
You had the most bizarre questions. How do you play a trivia game and then ask questions that nobody has any frame of reference to?
You got one right.
Did I?
Yeah.
No.
They weren't that bad, were they?
They were so far off the beaten path that they were just bizarro questions. But anyway, look. Show is okay to have fun. You know, we say that at work all the time. Work hard, have fun, give back. And even though this show is about jobs and introducing people to some of Jacksonville's most influential people, there's nothing wrong with having fun at every element of our job.
We might overdo it on the fun part, though.
Well, you know, we're already planning. You know, it's kind of funny. We're already planning our next Wacky Wednesday. We don't know what the theme's going to be. But, you know, we're in sales. We're recruiters. We find people jobs, and it takes a lot.
You got to mix it up.
Yeah, you have to have a lot of activity, a lot of massive. I'm calling a lot of people. Our recruiters talk to a lot of people every day. It's a lot of what could be a monotonous activity, even though every conversation is different, every person's different. You kind of mix it up a bit. But there's a lot of monotony that's part of the day. So we mix it up. And to have fun, what we'll do is we have these contests. They're activity and productivity-based contests, but there'll be a theme. We all dress up crazy, but we go the extra mile when we dress up, everybody. And then we end a little early, and we usually play, what's the name of that game?
Family Feud.
Oh, Family Feud.
Oh, I love that game.
Oh man, it's so competitive.
You know what's funny, James? You like this. Because we'll set up and we the teams have funny names. Like there'll be four people to a team on each side. So four versus four. And there'll be like four different teams because we got 20 some odd people, right? So we have all these teams going and they come up and either I host it or Tom does a really good job of hosting it too. And we go through all the motions that the host of Family Feud does. We ask the questions. We even have the buzzers that we put them in. They slap the buzzers. And so like we shut the office down early. There may or may not be an alcoholic beverage or two that is shared, you know.
You're an adult. It's fine.
Yeah, an adult. A couple adult beverages. But we laugh and have a really, really good
That's
time.
That's when the competitiveness comes out in our teams. Like, we know they're competitive because we're in sales, but my goodness, they do not want to lose.
Everybody wants to win Family Feud to the point where they're like, if someone misses a question, like, oh, come on. No, you know, it's so easy. Whispering. We see a little whispering. Hey, that's cheating.
Do the X too?
We do the
third time.
And we put it up on the board. I'm telling you, it's funny.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it is funny.
So speaking of activities, you might have forgotten, but this weekend. I've never done it, but it's in downtown Jacksonville. Our whole office is going. Well, maybe not all of them, but it's I want to say it's Alice in Wonderland. You have to dress in character and then you go and it's a scavenger hunt all through downtown. And you had to buy tickets in advance and it's sold out. But that's what our office is doing this weekend.
What does Jay mean by that's not for me? I'm not doing that.
Listen, the kids want to do it. So anyways, I heard it was a really cool event. So
that's super cool. It's the boat show this weekend.
Shows this weekend.
Well, you know.
We're not going to.
I know. I'm just saying. There's a lot going on. Jacksonville, there's a lot going on here.
Yeah.
And when we hear what Greg and what George was saying earlier about UPS and like they have 45.
I don't think I realized that Jacksonville was the fastest growing city for years.
Why wouldn't it be is what we keep saying, right? Because my favorite thing, the River City by the Sea, when they built out those ports, okay, Why would you ship to Miami or south to Tampa? Ship to Jacksonville. We have I-4 that's going to go east-west. We have I-95. This is where they meet right here. You don't have to ship another 5 hours from Miami up by road or another. They all have to get east-west or north-south, all of them. And here, Jacksonville is going to become the epicenter, right? And it has the largest landmass in the continental United States, right? More frontage, everything. It's unbelievable. But we also have relatively inexpensive labor. We have more universities that you can shake a stick at right here, so we have access to talent. And then the big-minded people like our guest a few weeks ago, Nick Howland, when he, some of the great incentives the city it puts together to attract these companies to pay great wages here, too. It's not coming here and get people to work for minimum wage. You're talking about bringing companies in with an average, they're going to bring in X jobs that are over $60,000 a year to start. It's pretty amazing. It's amazing.
You know they're putting a Four Seasons in downtown, right?
Stop it.
Yes.
Nobody
told
me that.
We're going to totally stay there.
Hey, you know what? We got to take this quick break real quick and listen to this message from our show sponsor. But when we come back, I want you to tell everybody about that seafood appetizer at Ruth's Chris. Okay? This is your show sponsor is going to come on right now, but come back right after this.
Hey, Jacksonville, it's me, Angie Langlois, one of the managing partners here at Ascendo Resources in Jacksonville, Florida. Ascendo Resources is an award-winning, certified, minority-owned staffing firm that specializes in placing highly skilled professionals on a temporary, temp-to-perm, or direct hire basis. Call the true professionals at Ascendo today, because despite the current challenges, our talented recruiters can find exactly what you need. Call me, Angie Langlois, at 904-479-9610.
All right, folks, that message was from our show sponsor, Ascendo Resources. If you need any staffing assistance, the semi-world famous Angie Langlois, she runs it. You know, I'm the eye candy. She runs the business there at Ascendo. But Angie, your new phone number is 904-663-2654.
I'm so glad you said that, because I forgot it. We went through a conversion and I have no idea what my number is.
I know they just changed it, but Angie's is
904-663-2654.
Yes.
Okay.
And mine is 904-663-2664. If Angie and I can ever help you in any way, if you need staffing assistance, whether you're a company that's looking for temporary or direct hire employees or really hard to find skill set, we can help you. If you're a person looking for that next step in your professional career, if we can't place you, we can point you in the right direction. And to all job seekers, we are always 100% free. And our advice is on point, because we've been doing this 25 years almost, and we've been doing it together, husband and wife team, right here in the beautiful River City by the Sea,
yes.
Jacksonville, Florida. So, Angie, okay.
I know you're going to ask this question because you're hungry.
Well, we went to Ruth's Chris all the time. And listen, you go to Ruth's Chris, a broccoli costs you $75, okay? It's nothing's cheap there, okay? So we had a gift certificate.
We had a special. Oh, yeah, we had a gift certificate.
So we go to Ruth's Chris, and we had heard from Elizabeth. Elizabeth told us about
The
Seafood Tower appetizer. That's amazing. Just tell everybody what it looks like.
Okay, so first of all, it says it's for two. It's like for eight. but you get lobster tails, you get clams, you get mussels, you get cocktail shrimp.
But they're big, like these monster prawns.
Yeah.
I'm like eating a corn on a cob, but it's a shrimp.
It's wonderful.
Amazing.
It's like two levels, too. So it's you start on the top.
It's tiered.
It has tiers. I thought it was three, but maybe it has two with ice and these things. And everything's so big and incredible that
like something they would give you in heaven right when you got there.
Right. Welcome.
I'm there now.
Yeah, welcome to heaven. Here's your dish. But, you know, after that, you get a steak, and it's like,
well, you shouldn't, because we're full after that.
you know, we had to, and I think they did, aren't there
two? Are you trying to say you want to go there and get that?
I'm trying to figure out. I am hungry.
Okay.
But are there two different, is there one like that's bigger than the other? You can get the big one or you can get the smaller one or no?
Yes.
Okay. And even, I think we got the smaller one and we just quit eating and said, you know, I hate to do this, but can you put this in the fridge or something? We're going to take that with us because there's no way I could eat this and then have a steak after it. There was no way.
So that's your food gem. We go out to eat all the time and that's your one food gem for the week. We should do that every week.
Yeah. Well, we know everywhere to go. Yes. I mean, we know where to go for, you know, casual seafood, for awesome seafood, for dive seafood. You know, we know those. We know where to have the best brunch that you would ever imagine. I think each week let's kind of share a little story because we do stuff. All right, guys, we got to get this part of the show is where we get our message from Boston Danny. Each week, Boston Danny gives us a Boston update, and Boston Danny is awesome. He's a great big part of the show. If you have a person you'd like to have recognized on the show, send me a note, Pete@PeteTheJobGuy.com, and I will give it to Boston Danny, and he'll give your person, whoever your special person is, a wicked piss of shout out like only Boston Danny can. With no further ado, let's get this week's Boston update from Boston Danny.
Hello, Jacksonville. Danny here with your Northern update. Well, I'm a little bit further south. I'm down in beautiful Barbados with Cheryl, enjoying ourselves a vacation. We're having a great time. I tell you, this island's everything they say it is. From the sunrise to the sunset, it's beautiful here. Back home, not so nice. It's still some crazy weather. It's, you know, starting to even out and get average. But, you know, this week, when I left, it was snowing. We were worried about getting out because of all the cancellations, you know, in other parts of the city coming through Boston. And but we got out fine, but it was snowing. It was icing. But, you know, Wednesday it was 55 degrees and, you know, pouring a monsoon. So you never know with New England folks. You can get a mild one, you could get a vicious one. All I know is down there in Barbados, they're all mild. The jet skiing, the sailing, and just, you know, everyone, they love surfing down here. The waves are unbelievable and they surf, they body surf and they boogie boarded. They play it right down here in Barbados. But, you know, the Celtics and the Bruins are still rolling on and, you know, the Patriots are making all the right choices. So too bad about Jacksonville. The Jags gave it a good run up there to the Super Bowl, but we'll all be watching it coming up. We got the big deciders happening and then the big game. So that's when it's going to be fun. But I'm liming down here in Barbados, watching cruise ships go by and bringing more tourists on board this island. They love the work of the hard workers. They're beautiful people, and they get the job done. They haven't sent me any shout-outs like you folks do, but, you know, you get them in here, I'll give you your birthdays and your anniversaries and all that stuff. So today I'd like to wish a wicked piss of birthday to Linda Scott, Allison Cavanaugh, Lisa Hallback, and Brennan Atkins. It's your day. Have a great day and do something nice for yourself, even if nobody else can do it for you. Brothers and sisters in Jacksonville, enjoy your weekend. Remember your first responders, your military, active, and serving proudly. And get down to the islands, folks. This is a little slice of heaven. Peter and Angie, take care. Give me a call.
Oh, another gem from Boston Danny. He keeps delivering each and every week, folks. Boston Danny, he gives you a Boston update. We're talking about, you know, today we had our guests, Greg and George, and they were talking about non-degreed successful professions. Do you know that Boston Danny has worked for E.M. Dugan for like 35 years? I mean, he's worked there his whole life. Boston Danny didn't go to college. And I remember when I met him at boot camp and he said, we were talking about, what are you going to do when you get out? And he said, I'm going to build something because I want to look over my shoulder when it's all said and done and say, I built that. And he's had a very successful career. What do you think, Hinch?
Go Boston Danny. But the net of the show, I mean, knowing everything we know about UPS, like what a wonderful organization and company. And hey, go eat the seafood tower.
Hi, everyone's Chris. That's what you take away. All right, folks, congratulations. You did it. You just listened to Hard Worker with Pete the Job Guy on 104.5 WOKV.